Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the last session of day one of the eFrames 2020. We've had a stellar lineup of sessions through the day. We've had industry leaders talking to representatives from the industry, representatives from the government, and today we have our country partner, Italy. The session is called Working with Italy, Tax Incentives, Regional Funds, and Co-Production Opportunities. We also have the Italian ambassador on this panel. To tell us more, I would like to invite Mr. Fabrizio Cuccarani, Trade Commissioner, Italian Trade Agency, Mumbai. Mr. Fabrizio, the stage is all yours.
Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone. As Italy, we strongly believe in Indo-Italian collaboration in the film industry, and that's why we have reconfirmed our participation to the virtual edition of FICCI Frames as partner country, even after the cancellation of physical event last March. We are attending the 5 days event with a large delegation, 29 companies and field commissions, and two webinar sessions. This is the first one, and the second will take place tomorrow at 6 o'clock, focused on animation co-production. I would like to invite all of you to visit our virtual booths at the Italian Pavilion and request for a meeting to Italian companies' representatives. So far, about 160 meetings have been requested by Indian companies to Italian delegation. Now, I would like to introduce you, our dignitaries and speakers, starting from His Excellency Vincenzo De Luca, Ambassador of Italy to India, Mr. Francesco Rutelli, President of ANICA, Italian Film Audiovisual Multimedia Industries Association, Mr. Roberto Stabile, Head of International Department of ANICA, Mrs. Cristina Priarone, President of Italian Film Commissions, and Andrea Spagna, Advisor to the President and CEO of Istituto Luce Cinecittà. Now we can start, and I will leave the floor to our ambassador in New Delhi, Mr. Vincenzo De Luca. Please, Ambassador.
Thank you, Fabrizio. Namaste. Buon pomeriggio. Good afternoon. And thank you very much for inviting Italy to participate as partner country to FICCI eFrame 2020. I had the pleasure this morning to attend the inaugural session of the event with the Indian authorities and FICCI, who I once again thank for the extensive work carried out to make this appointment possible, but also a productive one. I would also like to thank the Italian institution present in this session, and in particular, the Italian Trade Agency, ANICA, the Italian Association of Cinematographic and Audiovisual Industry, represented by President Francesco Rutelli and Head of International Department Roberto Stabile, along with the Film Commission and Istituto Luce Cinecittà. As you very well know, we were planning a series of great events in Mumbai in March, and we were quite saddened by the fact that we had to put everything on hold, but at the same time, we were confident that the work that had been done up to then wouldn't be lost. Fortunately, COVID didn't stop FICCI and Italy, and here we are today on a new, innovative, and catchy digital platform. We were enthusiastic that FICCI was able to reorganize and very happy to learn that all the relevant actors that were working on Italy partnership to this very important moment for the creative industry were keen in joining virtual as well. We have a rich delegation of companies from the Italian creative industry that we will have an opportunity to meet their counterparts in B2B meeting and develop common projects. We also have the opportunity to present to the Indian most qualified audience our creative industry, our beautiful location as shooting destination, and the incentive to attract foreign production. In fact, Italy creative industry is one of the strongest in the world. Not many know that thanks to our craftsmanship in the field of cinema, Italy ranks second after the United States for number of Academy Awards received. This is thanks to our excellences among set designer, photographer, costume designer, makeup artist, composer. We lost yesterday one of them, Maestro Ennio Morricone. I dedicated a tribute to him this morning in my opening speech. Culture is indeed one of the drivers of the Italian economy. The creative industry in Italy accounts for 6% of our GDP and 14% of our export. The internationalization of the Italian creative industry is key not only to support economic growth, but is also in Italy, like in India, representative of our soft power all over the world. As ambassador of Italy to India, I strongly believe that cinema plays a crucial role in the culture and economic relation between our two countries. It significantly helps in understanding each other's culture, tradition, and lifestyle. Italy and India are two superpowers of the creative industry. And it's why we need to establish a strategic partnership to boost our respective industry. Italy can support an European and global projection of Bollywood, while Bollywood can give Italy a more Asian and global projection for our shooting destinations and production. This is why we have to continue building on what we have achieved so far and what will come from this week of meetings and conference. With this in mind, allow me to reiterate our invitation to the Bollywood industry, FICCI, to participate as a focus country of the events organized by ANICA for the Ministry of Culture, Heritage and Activities and Tourism at the Venice Production Bridge during the 77th Venice International Film Festival. Italy already hosts many film productions every year from India. We are proud of this result, but we hope to do more together. The state of the art technology, the incredible diversity of the Italian territory, the rapidity in getting the required permission, the interesting rebate and incentive provided both at the national and regional level in Italy for shooting make our country an increasingly sought after shooting destination. You will learn all about it in this session. To facilitate the work of our companies, we have been working extensively with the Union Ministry of Broadcasting and Entertainment and are in the process of finalizing a bilateral audiovisual co-production agreement, which will provide a framework for the development of even stronger audiovisual relationship for film, television, and video co-production. In this context, the Italian Film Commission Association, that counts over 17 film commissions scattered over the country, is already doing a great job in facilitating access to sites and providing useful services to foreign producers and filmmakers. Let's continue to work together and help our respective audience to get wider access to our entertainment industry. Many thanks for your attention. Viva l'Italia, viva l'India, FICCI Frame, Daniavat.
Thank you, Ambassador, for your speech, and also thank you for your daily support given to us together with all other partners present today here for organizing this event and for organizing the Italian participation at FICCI IFRAMES. Now I would like to ask President Francesco Rutelli to give his speech. Please, President.
Thank you very much. I'm very honored and proud to be here with you. It's also to witness that the fact that we missed a classical, let's say, FICCI Frames event. We are here to show and to display our determination to cooperate, work together, preparing other events. What Ambassador De Luca just said about the opportunity we want to have in Venice has to be taken very seriously, and we are ready to cooperate with the Italian government, with Venice Biennale, and all the ecosystem, the Italian ecosystem. I think the most important thing to say today is that we do represent an ecosystem that is vibrant. We are perfectly acknowledged about the strategic importance of India in the audiovisual cinema arena. You are here to stay, and we are here to stand together and work together. So I'm very glad that many Italian companies attend this FICCI edition, very, very special edition. I'm very happy that you will hear about very concrete measures that can be undertaken through our cooperation in Italy to support your companies and to allow our companies to work in India and with Indian partners. It is very important that a co-production agreement is now in force. It is very, very important that everybody in India know how much Italy can give in terms of tax credit, both and at the same time through national, governmental resources and regional resources. It is very important to understand how rooted and efficient are our film commission. Cristina Priarone will shortly give you a vision about that. It is a very, very, very vibrant reality. I can tell you that I started it mid-90s when I was the mayor of Rome with the first Italian Film Commission. But since then, so many, many, such a long road has been really achieved. So, locations and destination, co-production agreement, tax credit for national and regional funding. And finally, you got an excellent ambassador of Italy in India, and his team, and of course the ICE, our host, and the trade commissioner of ITA. You're a fantastic team. We are here to serve. We are here to help our companies. And allow me to display our really strategic goal. We want to cooperate with India. We want to use also next FICCI Frames event to in ordinary times, we do hope. But starting from Venice, again, Roberto Stabile is here with me. He will continue his dedication to support all our ecosystem in this shared mission. The very last thing I would like to say is about Ennio Morricone, because just 1 year and a half ago in the Video Città event here in Rome, where India was the guest country with a very successful series of events, we had a touching event in the most ancient university, that is also a very modern, contemporary university, Università La Sapienza in Rome, created more than 700 years ago. And together we had two person, both two times Academy Award winners, Ennio Morricone and A.R. Rahman from Bollywood, came, spoke together. And what Mr. Rahman said to Ennio Morricone is very important. He said, we, through music and films, we shut down barriers and we built friendship. Honoring today my great friend Ennio Morricone and the vibrant Indian industry means that we do want to continue and we do want to be stronger and even more friendly together. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you for your words and thank you also for your support. Before giving the floor to Mrs. Priarone, I just want to remind all of you that we have 13 field commissions present at the Italian Pavilion. So in addition to what Mrs. Priarone is telling now, in few minutes, you can have all the information, most regional information about the incentives that the regions, the Italian regions, offer to the producers, just asking or setting up meetings with the film commissions present here. Thank you. Now I will leave the floor to Mrs. Cristina Priarone, President of Italian Film Commission.
Thank you, and good morning, everybody. And thank you too. First of all, I want to thank the Friends of Frames and the Ambassador Vincenzo De Luca and ITA Trade Agency for this occasion, because I've been at Frames many times and really I hope to be again there in the next occasion. I think it's a very important market and occasion for all that area for us. I would like to highlight you in a few minutes all the opportunities you can get throughout our association, IFC, Italian Film Commission, and throughout our associated members. All the association has got 19 members, and the one mentioned by Mr. Giustarini are the two commissions available for the participation at Frames. And we are located all around the country. Every Italian region has got his full commission, and to this structure belong funds, assistance for audiovisual industry, and the opportunities. First of all, I think it's important to let you know that the Italian regional funds all together reach out an amount of 50 million euro. So this added to the national funds in Italy make our country really powerful and interesting for the international market in audiovisual. So I think Italy now, as President Rutelli said before, it's we can say it's a very interesting country for co-production and for audiovisual for many reasons, for location, for the high level of professional, but also for funds. Our association has got a board. I'm on the board, I'm the president, and also two vice presidents are working with me, Luca Ferrario of Trentino Film Commission and Paolo Manera of Piemonte Film Commission. And together, we work together and we help all the region and the Film Commission of Italy to work with efficiency and to be ready and together to face the international market. But every Italian region is a universe. So I would like to give you just throughout one word the idea of the opportunity of each Italian territory. Don't be afraid, it will take just a few minutes. So we start from the north and we go to the south very, very quickly, but just going to the key point for the international producer. We start from Val d'Aosta. It's a wonderful territory with fun and especially keen in Castel, for Castel location. Then we go, we are in the north of Italy, the western part, and we go to Piemonte Fruit Commission, the oldest fruit commission in Italy. They are very keen for funds and funds for documentary. Then we go to the region of Milan, very famous for fashion system, Lombardia Fruit Commission. And they don't have so many funds, but the main TV production companies are located in that area. And that area is very keen in the production of commercials, so, and of TV series, the famous one. Then we go in the north, but the eastern part of Italy with Trentino Fruit Commission, they have funds, and especially they have funds for the production which keep an eye on green matters. They have funds dedicated to the green production. Then we go to IDM, Südtirol Alto Adige. It's a food commission with the rich funds and also very useful for co-productions with Austria and Germany. It's very useful and, let me say, also beautiful to co-product with the European countries and also with more than one. It's easy to do this throughout the Italian food commission. Then we go in the famous region of Venice, the Veneto Food Commission is a brand new food commission. They are right now starting, they have funds, and they are ready to welcome you. Then we go at the very eastern part of Italy, on the sea, the Friuli Venezia Giulia. They are rich with funds, very good for assistance, and also very useful in finding co-production with Eastern Europe. They have many markets working on this direction. Then we go on the sea in the north, the Liguria Fruit Commission, the region of the famous Portofino, very famous for the seaside and for the historical center. They can help you and give you funds. And now we start going in the center of Italy. We start from Emilia-Romagna, very important region this year because it's Fellini's region. And this is the year, the anniversary of the birth of Fellini. So they have many initiatives and they have funds also. Then we go down in the center and we go in Tuscany, famous all over the world for the countryside and for the Renaissance heritage. Then we go to Marche Fruit Commission, a very specialized in countryside location and cultural location. It's land to discover and they have funds and they are a fruit commission internal to the region, so they can help you very quickly with funds. Then we go to the Lazio. By the way, I'm also the general director. The ninth, the Roma-Lazio Fruit Commission, so it's the capital region. The 90%, we can say, of the Italian sector in audiovisual art is located in our region, and it's interesting to let you know that we have a fund specially dedicated to co-production, 10 million euro funds for Lazio-based producer, but which will co-produce with foreign producer. Then we go to Umbria, a bright new food commission. They are building up a new fund, and they don't have sea, but they have a wonderful, wonderful small cities full of cultural heritage and really medieval masterpieces. Then we go to Campania, a very, very good location, region, and very famous for TV series. Just one title, Gomorra, famous all over the world, has been shot there. They have funds and they can give you assistance. Then we go to Lucana Fruit Commission in the south of Italy. One thing, first of all, the last 007 has been shot there. They have funds and they can assist you very well. Then we go in the very south with Apulia Fruit Commission, a very keen food commission and very useful for funds. And then we go to Calabria, a quite new food commission. They work hardly since 3 or 4 years, a land totally to discover with high mountains and sea and plants available for you. And then we go to our two islands, Sicily and Sardinia, wonderful territories, and both of them has got funds, and especially Sardinia has got funds dedicated to hospitality, if you would like to come and have location tour. So just 3 minutes to give you highlights and ideas of our regions, very various, very different, and really ready to welcome you with funds and opportunities. And throughout the full commission, you will have the best services and facilities. And let me say, throughout our association, you can contact us and we can put you in touch directly with the full commission of the territory in which you are interested. And I would like also to highlight you our next occasion, which is the MIA market, is an international market in Rome, very good to work together. And so you can find us also in that occasion in November. And so we are ready to welcome you. India is in our heart. We worked very much with India a few years ago, and we are ready to start again with all the Italy country ready for you. So feel free to contact us and to ask us every information, and we will find the best opportunity for you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Priarone. Thank you for the presentation of Italy. And if we can summarize in just one word, Italy, I would say the word would be location, because we have everything. We have sea, we have beautiful beaches, we have mountains, we have lakes, we have heritage, we have historical cities. And now we can say that also we have funds. So we have funds for co-production. We have funds for also Indian producers. So I would invite them to take advantage of this opportunity that Italy and the Italian Field Commission is giving to you. Thank you very much, Mrs. Priarone.
Thank you.
Now, last but not least, I would like to introduce Mr. Andrea Spagna. As I said, he is the advisor of president and CEO of Istituto Luce Cinecittà, and he will present Cinecittà Shows Off. Please, Mr. Spagna.
Thanks, Fabrizio. Thanks, Cristina. I'm Andrea Spagna. I'm Marketing and Business Development Director for Istituto Luce. And I'm here to share with you some update regarding Cinecittà. As you said, Italy is about location, is about beautiful place, but also there is a place in Rome, is a studio and is an icon and is an important center of production for the film industry. First of all, I would like to thank the Fitch Frame team and for the opportunity, and my Italian partners, so ITA e ICE, and the Italian Embassy, ANICA, MIPACT, and also the Italian Film Commission. And also, I would like to say good luck to Maria Pia Ammirati, new president of Luce Cinecittà, who has just joined the company. I guess many of you have already know the name Cinecittà in Italy, I'm sure. Yes, probably, I guess also in India. This is because Cinecittà is an icon, a very strong Italian brand like Ferrari or Vespa, known all over the world mainly for the glory of its past. As for Hollywood, or mainly Bollywood, Cinecittà reminds us the essence of cinema, the art of filmmaking. For filmmakers, director, actor, and talent is considered a temple of cinema. 3,000 movies have been shot since its foundation in 1937, then more than 80 years ago, more than 50, and won an Academy Awards. But first, the good news I would like to share with you is Cinecittà is not only the glory of the past, is still an excellence of the present, is a world-class production studio, is one of the biggest and most important studio in Europe. At Cinecittà, we have more than 19 sound stage, different size, from the small one of 40K square feet to the 30K square feet, the most important, the stage 5 of the famous Fellini one, a large backlot of 1 million square feet, and we do offer, differently from the other studio, in-house set construction and post-production audio and video services. Moreover, we are really very, very close from Rome. It's 10 minutes from an airport and 20 minutes by underground from the center of Rome. That you arrive right, you arrive just outside the main entrance that you see on my behind on my shoulder. The second good news is that since July 2017, after 20 years of private management, Cinecittà is again public under the governance of Istituto Luce Cinecittà. Istituto Luce Cinecittà is an important public institution that is involved in many different activities of the Italian audiovisual industry. It manages the famous Archive Luce, which is a huge collection of video and photo covering the whole history of the 20th century of Italy, and is included in the UNESCO Heritage Register. Support the Italian cinema in Italy abroad, organizing cultural exhibition and the Italian presence in major festival, and now also is in charge of managing the Cinecittà studio business, offering spaces and tech services to the audiovisual production, and take care also the permanent exhibition of Cinecittà Shows Off, which attracts everyday students and tourists who are curious to discover more about this fascinating place. In January 2020, we opened inside the Cinecittà a new museum that is the Museo MIAC, the new Italian Museum of Moving Images, a very innovative project which aimed to present the Italy immense heritage audiovisual with new eyes through an immersive experience and interactive installation. So, coming back to Cinecittà, 3 years back, the government realized that if you want to compete effectively in this global content production booming, you need to have a location, you have to be a significant and effective incentive, but you have to also to present a studio in order to have a one-stop shop offer in order to gain and to compete effectively in this market. So decided to acquire the studio and to invest an important bunch of money to renew the location, the facilities, and also to add more spaces. The third good news is that after the dramatic pandemic, Cinecittà is back. COVID, of course, has hit dramatically our business, as for everybody. All the production have been forced to stop. But at the same time, Italy applied a strict lockdown that now seems to show the benefits. We are now in a situation that is better than compared to other countries. And so we can have a little advantage on the production market. Cinecittà is back. Many productions are returning to work in total safety and compliance with the new protocol. We all have known there is a new, very well-known Italian TV show that is now starting the selection of its program, and an important TV series based on Ancient Rome that should start shooting in a few days. And also we are receiving and started receiving many important requests from international production that are evaluating a studio as a better option for a based production. The COVID is a game changer, will drastically change also the business model and the industry, and probably will accelerate some trends that are already in place. We will travel a little less, we'll probably have smaller crews, and this will lead to reviewing the need of the production and will make the studio a safer place where probably it can be easier to comply with the new measure and new safety measure. Moreover, the adoption of technology, digital effect, and VFX will rise and will increase definitely. For this reason, we have decided to anticipate some of our projects that we have in our investment plan. We will soon have a new sound stage that will be dressed by a 360 green screen, where will be possible with the latest technology of Unreal Engine, pre-visualization, all the latest digital technology, will be possible to recreate any virtual location scenography, when will be in order to ease the work of the production that cannot go all around the world to make maybe a little shot. Furthermore, to make life easier to our customer, producer, set designer, and lamp producer, from our website, we launch a new feature. It's possible now going to our website and going to see the sheet of our soundstage, for example, the stage 5. You can go and see and explore our soundstage in a virtual reality, with also some new content. You can see the measure, the quotes, all the technical specification, and also you can imagine a virtual scenography. So the professional can stay from their home in the US or in India and just analyze and explore our space. And so they don't have necessary to come here just for a recce. But we don't stop here. We know that international production is growing, and we are sure that we will start, because the new player is the arena, and the competitive arena with the new streamer is crowded. There are now Amazon that is coming and is growing. There is Netflix that is already in Italy. We have Apple that is will grow for sure. Quibi, that is a newcomer. So all these people are competing for content, and probably they will need and produce more and more content, and they will need studio. So, and they will need large spaces. So we are in plan to build two new large sound stage, about 3,500 square meter, and also a tank, a swimming pool for underwater shooting. We hope to get this plan ready within the next 2 years. Cinecittà is also a sought after and suggestive location for corporate and private events. We hosted a very important event, private wedding, very important. Obviously, the COVID has made this activity more difficult. But even in this moment, we reacted very quickly. And now we are able to offer a platform to manage corporate event in streaming, but with a limited audience inside our studio. At the same time, another nice initiative at the time of COVID is the drive-in. We host this little project that started early in July, and which combine the romantic vintage of watching a movie from the car with the audio coming from the radio, with the latest technology to book that allow to book the food and to reserve the seat directly from an app. So to close my presentation, I would love to say that Cinecittà is a truly unique place where art, excellence, and magic are combined together to make any dream come true. Thank you for your time and attention. I hope to welcome you in Cinecittà for your next project, for a collaboration, or even also just for a visit. That is a really must-see place. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Spagna. Thank you for reminding us the importance of Cinecittà and of its studios, which together with the locations, makes Italy like a real very important destination for production. Now, while we wait for any questions should comes from the audience, I would like to ask Mr. Roberto Stabile, head of International Department of Anika, to say some words.
Thank you, Director Giustarini. I would like to say only thank you to all the friends from FutureFrame, from our ambassador, from you, Italian Trade Agency. We are very happy to be here today, and I hope we can very, very soon fly to meet each other together physically. We wait for you in Venice in September, as our ambassador say. I hope to come very soon to India. We have many, many B2B meetings during FutureFrame, and I hope that many, many Italian co-production will be done after this first edition of FutureFrame. Many people must go to Cinecittà because that's a real iconic place, and hope to see all of you very, very soon, physically and not only in the screen. Thank you so much.
I agree.
Thank you, Mr. Stabile. Ambassador, would you like to say something for closing?
Just thank you, Fabrizio. Thank again, President Francesco Rutelli, Roberto Stabile, Andrea Spagna, Film Commission. I'm so happy because it was a challenge for us to be present this year, this E-edition of FutureFrame. I remember when I told Roberto why we don't try to be here also these circumstances, and we succeed because we really believe that there is a great potential between Italy and India in the movie production and co-production, and also we can attract production from India, we can also have production here in India. I think we are two strategic partners for this industry. Our soft power is really much fueled with this activity, with the creative industry, with cinema, with movie. And this morning I also remember that since the 50s there were links between the Italian cinema and the Indian cinema. If you think about one of the most important movie director, Satyajit Ray from India, he won an award in Venice in 1984. And he was inspired by our directors in the 50s, like De Sica, Rossellini. So it's really a long story of friendship, of interaction, of collaboration. And now we are in the condition to really enhance this partnership between Italy and India. So thank you so much, Fiki. Thank you so much, Annika. Thank you, the Italian Trade Agency. And I think this is only a step forward, but we will work starting from Venice. Hope that somebody from here can also be physically present in Venice. Anyway, we will do our best to have this focus India in Venice. Thank you.
Thank you, Ambassador. I don't see any questions, so I would like to thank all the speakers, all the attendants, all the Italian, the Indian people who was with us today, and I renew my invitation to visit our Italian pavilion and meet our companies present there. Thank you very much. Thank you again. Bye.
Thank you, Fabrizio. Thank you, Ambassador. Thank you, guests. It's been a wonderful session. Thank you for giving us an insight into what Italy can offer, and we look forward to more collaboration between India and Italy, and some really nice creative stuff coming out of this collaboration. Thank you.
We will see you tomorrow.
The session is at 12 in the afternoon tomorrow. Thank you very much. See you. Good night.
See you. Bye. Thank you.